हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, पिछले दो लेक्चर से हम लोग एविडेंसेस ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक इवोल्यूशन पढ़ रहे हैं, जिसमें वी आर एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू डिसप्रूव द थ्योरी ऑफ स्पेशल क्रिएशन व्हिच स्टेट्स दैट ऑल द लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स वर फॉर्म्ड ऑल ऑफ अ सडन आउट ऑफ नथिंग एंड दे डू नॉट हैव एनी इंटर रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन देम. And with help of these evidences, we are also trying to justify the concept of organic evolution by proving interrelationship between organisms belonging to the different groups. All these evidences, they are broadly categorized in four categories, which are morphological and anatomical evidences, paleontological evidences, embryological evidences, and biochemical and physiological evidences. And in this first category of morphological and anatomical evidences, we have already studied homologous organ, analogous organ, connecting links and the missing links. And today we will continue with the next type of evidences, which are the vestigial organ. So first of all, what are the vestigial organ? These are the organs which are non-functional in the possessor, but were functional in its ancestors and are also functional in the related animals. So these vestigial organs, ऐसे organs को हम लोग बोलते हैं जो जिस organism में ये अभी present हैं उसमें तो ये काम नहीं करते हैं, means non-functional हैं, but उसके ancestors में they were functional. Many examples of vestigial organs are there. Some of them include, for example, wings and feathers in the flightless birds. जो फ्लाइटलेस बर्ड्स होते हैं जैसे ऑस्ट्रिच, कीवी, ईमू एट्सेट्रा, इन सब ऑर्गेनिजम्स में क्योंकि ये फ्लाई नहीं कर सकते हैं बट स्टिल दे हैव विंग्स एंड फेदर्स लाइक ऑल अदर बर्ड्स विच प्रूव्स द इंटर रिलेशनशिप ऑफ दीज फ्लाइटलेस बर्ड्स विद द अदर बर्ड्स. अनदर एग्जाम्पल इज द स्प्लिंट बोन्स इन द लिम्स ऑफ द हॉर्स. हॉर्स के लिम्स के जो सेकेंड और फोर्थ डिजिट होते हैं दे आर टर्म्ड एज द स्प्लिंट बोन. हॉर्स इज अडेप्टेड फॉर रनिंग और द कर्सोरियल मोड ऑफ लोकोमोशन एंड ड्यूरिंग द कोर्स ऑफ इवोल्यूशन हॉर्स का जो थर्ड डिजिट है इट हैज़ गॉट इलोंगेटेड वेरी मच एंड अदर फोर डिजिट्स दे प्रोग्रेसिवली रिड्यूस्ड आउट ऑफ विच द फर्स्ट एंड द फिफ्थ डिजिट दे डिसअपीयर्ड कम्प्लीटली बट second and fourth digit are still present but they are highly reduced and non-functional, so we term them as the vestigial organ. Other examples include the eyes in the cave animals, the vestiges of hind limb and pelvic girdle bones in snakes like python and sand boa, and in Greenland whales also. Human beings also has many examples of vestigial organ. Few of them include the nictitating membrane or the plica semilunaris, which is actually a non-functional pinkish fold present at the inner angle of our eye, but this nictitating membrane is functional in many other animals where it functions as for cleaning of the cornea of the eye. Other example include the coccyx or the tail bone. Human beings may, although tail nahi present hota hai, but still all human beings they have a very small and reduced coccygeal vertebra at the end of their vertebral column, which is their tailbone. And another example is the appendix in our alimentary canal. In human beings, appendix is non-functional, but in many other animals, especially in herbivores, appendix is functional, present in functional form. So these are some of the examples of the vestigial organs. Next category is the category of evidences are the atavism and reversion. Atavism is the phenomenon of reappearance or refunctioning of some organs which are either completely lost during the course of evolution or are present as vestigial organ. This atavism indicates the ancestral history of the organism. Few examples of atavism in case of human beings, they are enlisted here. For example, the birth of a human baby with a small tail. Although this is a very rare phenomenon, but sometimes human babies are born with a small tail, which proves that humans have evolved from ancestors which had tails, or human have evolved from the tailed ancestors. Another example is the power of moving pinna of the ear. आप में से कुछ लोग शायद ऐसे लोगों को जानते होंगे जो थोड़ा बहुत अपना ईयर का जो पिन्ना होता है उसको मूवमेंट कर सकते हैं. दिस इज़ एक्चुअली ड्यू टू द फैक्ट दैट इन दोज पर्सन्स द ऑरिकुलर मसल्स विच हेल्प इन मूवमेंट ऑफ द पिन्ना बिकम फंक्शनल एज इन मोस्ट ऑफ द अदर मैमल्स लाइक डॉग्स कैटल्स हॉर्स एट्सेट्रा. इन ऑर्गेनिजम्स के ऑरिकुलर मसल्स फंक्शनल होते हैं बट ह्यूमन बींग्स में ऑरिकुलर मसल्स दे हैव they are present in form of vestigial organ but sometimes due to the phenomenon of atavism or reversion these auricular muscles they become functional and this proves the relationship of man with other mammals. There are few other examples of atavism in case of human beings which are enlisted here. And next category of evidences of organic evolution are the paleontological evidences, which are actually the evidences based on the study of the fossils. And fossils are the remains or impressions of the ancient organisms which are preserved in the sedimentary rocks, and paleontology is the study of the fossils. So in the category of the paleontological evidences, we will basically study two types of evidences. First are the missing links, which we have already done, and second is the phylogenetic study or the study of evolutionary history of organism based on the fossil record, in which we will do the phylogeny of horse. हॉर्स का फाइलोजेनी ये टॉपिक आपको आपका सिलेबस में अलग से भी मैंशनड है. सो दिस द टॉपिक ऑफ फाइलोजेनी ऑफ हॉर्स वी विल डू लेटर इन डिटेल. सो दिस इज़ ऑल अबाउट टूडेज लेक्चर. थैंक यू.